Welcome to What is School of Languages? Today, we are going to study nouns in French. Les noms. The objectives of the lesson. By the end of this lesson, the people will be able to identify the gender of noun, know why gender is important. All right. Let's quickly have a look at the lesson. Noun and gender. In order to know the gender of a noun, you need to study the definite and indefinite articles. So it means this lesson, we are going to study the definite and indefinite articles. Note that most of the words ending in E are feminine, and most words ending in consonants and not in E are masculine. There are many exceptions to this rule. Masculine, le, un. It means masculine, le, and un articles are used before a masculine noun. Feminine, la and une. These articles are used before a feminine noun. Plural, les and des. These articles are used before plural noun, regardless of the gender. Either it is feminine or masculine. It doesn't matter here, provided the noun is in plural form. Examples, masculine and feminine. When you look at the table below, you can see that we have masculine, le and un, stylo, feminine, la and une, fleur, plural, le and des. So you can clearly understand that the le and un is for masculine singular noun, le, un stylo, la, une fleur, le, des stylo, les des fleurs. Let's continue. Knowing that les and des are used for plural nouns, it is important to know the agenda too. Yes, if you say the table, what is the agenda of table? You should know. Here are five reasons why it is important to know the gender of a noun. Let's have a look at them. Why gender is important, the part two of this lesson. Reason one is very important. Pay attention to what we are going to study now. All adjectives agree in number and gender with the noun they qualify. All adjectives agree in number and gender with the noun they qualify. Examples. Le stylo vert est petit. Please pay attention to what I am going to teach you in this lesson so that you not find yourself wanting when you are using le or la, un or une, l apostrophe. So pay attention here, please. Have time with me, okay? Thank you. Le stylo vert est petit. The green pen is small. La fleur verte est petite. The green flower is small. You can say in English, small and green still remain the same. They don't change. But for French, they will change because they have gender. Stylo is masculine gender. Fleur is feminine gender. And you see that when we have stylo as masculine gender, the adjective vert of color, the adjective of color vert and the other adjective petit change their form. So we have le stylo vert, la fleur verte. You can notice that when changing the gender, the adjective adds E. That's what I said. Good. This one shows that the agreement that happens when the article changes. That shows that the agreement happens when the article changes. It means that the article determines the gender of the noun. Example, Les stylos verts sont petits. Now we have changed the article. We look at the word vert and petit. They have also been modified. We have an S to the vert and S to the petit. The green pens are small. Since stylo is masculine, we will add only S to the adjectives. Les fleurs vertes sont petites. The green flowers are small. We have added E because it is a feminine word, and an S because it is a plural word. You can clearly understand here that when you take le stylo est vert, le stylo vert est petit, is masculine singular. When you move to the plural, les stylos verts sont petits, since it is masculine, you only add S because we are talking about plural here. When you say les fleurs vertes sont petites, already fleur is feminine and plural, so you have to add ES to the adjective. Remember that all colors are adjectives. Blanc is adjective, so it's an adjective of color. They will always be modified when you use the feminine gender. Now, reason two, why gender is important. Reason two, all possessive pronouns and adjectives agree in number and gender with the noun used. Examples, mon stylo est vert, my pen is green. We use mon because stylo is masculine. So the mon is a possessive adjective here. Since stylo is masculine, you have to use mon. Le mien est vert, that is the possessive pronoun. Le mien, replacing the word mon stylo. Le mien est vert, mine is green. Since stylo is masculine, you use le mien and vert as well. Ma fleur est verte. Aha, there's a change here. My fleur est verte. My flower is green. We use ma and not mon because fleur is feminine. So what can we say? All possessive adjectives agree with the actual gender of the word, but not with the possessor. Let me be clear here. I am a male person talking. So I'm talking about my flower. Here, the agreement is done with the noun I'm using, but not my gender. So the adjective agree with the noun I am referring to, but not my gender. So the noun of the gender. Good. La mienne est verte. We use la mienne because it agrees with flower, which is feminine. Mes stylos sont verts. My pens are green. We use mes and verts with S because stylo is plural. In English, you say, my car is green. Here you say, her car is green. The adjective you are using, her, refers to the person, but not the possessor. Not the thing possessed. But in French, the opposite is the case. It refers to the thing possessed, but not the possessor. Good. Les miens sont verts. Possessive pronoun here, les miens, replaces mes stylos. Mine agrees. Everything agrees. Les miens, verts, and all have S because it is masculine, feminine. Mes fleurs sont vertes. My flowers are green. We use vertes with an ES because flower is feminine plural. Les miennes sont vertes. Mine are green. We use les miennes because flower is feminine plural. Reason three. The first was adjectives. Now, reason two, possessive adjective and possessive pronoun. Now they say, demonstrative pronouns and adjectives agree in gender and number with the noun used. Examples, Stylo, a verb, you know, the ce is a demonstrative adjective, this or that. This pen is green. Celui-ci est vert. That's the possessive demonstrative pronoun. Celui-ci est vert. This one is green. We use ce and celui-ci because stylo is masculine singular noun. Cette fleur est verte. Cette. C-E-T-T-E. Est verte. This flower is green. Celle-ci est verte. We use sex and celle-ci because flower is feminine singular noun. Interesting here. Ces stylos sont verts. These pens are green. Ceux-ci sont verts. This is the plural of the first example. The ces stylos est vert. These pens are green. These ones are green. We use ces and ceux-ci because stylo is feminine plural noun. The last part, ces fleurs sont vertes. Celles-ci sont vertes. These flowers are green. These ones are green. We use ces and celles-ci because flower is feminine plural noun. I hope you get it. All right. Reason four, all interrogative pronouns and adjectives agree in number and gender with the noun used. Example, quel stylo est sur la table? Which pen is on the table? Since stylo is masculine singular, the quel remains like this. Don't say quel, say quel. Quel stylo sont sur la table? Here we are talking in plural form of the masculine singular. So there's an S added to it. Which pens are on the table? Here, quel takes one L and an S because stylo is masculine plural. Quelle fleur est sur la table? Which flower is on the table? Quel S is spelled double L-E because flower is feminine. Quelle fleur sont sur la table? Which flower are on the table? Quel is spelled double L-E-S because flower is feminine plural. Reason five, that is the last reason. When conjugating a verb, the subject pronoun agree with the number and gender of the noun it replaces. Mm-hmm. Example, le stylo est vert, the pen is green. Il est vert, we are replacing the stylo with a personal pronoun. It is same like Kofi is going to school. He is going to school. So this is a subject pronoun. We replace le stylo with a because le stylo is masculine singular. La fleur est verte. Elle est verte. You replace la fleur with elle because la fleur is feminine singular. Les stylos sont verts. The pens are green. Ils sont verts. They are green. Les fleurs sont vertes. The flowers are green. Elles sont vertes. It's obvious. Note, the subject pronoun will always agree with the adjective. The subject pronoun will always agree with the adjective. In the previous example, that is the number four, we say les fleurs sont vertes. We are replacing les fleurs with elle. So the subject pronoun has to agree with the adjective because the subject pronoun is feminine, therefore the adjective becomes feminine. If the subject pronoun is masculine, definitely the adjective becomes masculine. More reasons. We are going to have a look at the more reasons why gender is important. The past participle must agree in gender in number with the subject when using the auxiliary verb in the passé composé. Aller, for example, you say, je suis allé, tu es allé, il est allé, elle est allé, nous sommes allés, vous êtes allés, ils sont allés, elles sont allées. look on your screen and you can see clearly that when you say je suis allé, I am a male person, the allé will not take another E. But if the person is a female, the allé will take another E. Then you remove the brackets. Tu es allé, when we are referring to a female person, you remove the bracket, add another E. Il est allé, you already know that the il is he. So there will be no changing or agreeing with the subject pronoun. Elle est allée, to agree with it, meaning that another E has to be added. Nous sommes allés, you see two brackets here. It can be that we have only male, then you don't add the other E, but you add the S. Vous êtes allés is when we have only female that we add ES. Ils sont allés is already de masculine. Elles sont allées de feminine. In that case, we do the agreement straightforward. Practice. You are going to have an activity on this before we close for the day. Form now from masculine to feminine. I entreat you to come back next time because I can see that you are tired. So next time when we come back, we are going to do this activity. Thank you very much for watching. Merci. Au revoir. Bye-bye.